rights are human rights.
Our topic is a call for action, and there is indeed certainly a lot to do. Jewish communities are like a sensitive seismograph, a reflection of what is going on. There was a very thorough survey taken by the FRA, Fundamental Rights Agency in Europe, which is a branch of the European Union. And they interviewed some 6,000 Jews from 8 European countries and asked them what do they think and what do they feel about the situation. And it was a novelty because generally what you have is surveys about anti-Semitic activities and expressions. But this time, Jews were asked for their opinion. And they, some 75% answered that they think and feel that anti-Semitism has worsened in recent years, has worsened. Some 25% regularly do not leave home with the kippah. And since the survey was done, there are a lot more instructions from rabbis, from leaders, asking Jews in Europe, especially central and western one, Belgium, France, others, northern Italy, not to leave home with a kippah or other identifying items, Magen David, a bag with a Hamashbir Letzorchan or whatever. So, 25% do not go out with a kippah. Same number avoids going to Jewish events. I'm speaking about Europe. Avoids going to Jewish events because most of the attacks on the person of people takes place when coming in or going out of a place that is known to be a Jewish institute. There is in Germany what is called today Holocaust fatigue. Holocaust fatigue, which means enough is enough, we are tired. I'm not saying that it is all over. I'm not saying that it is in the higher political echelons at the head of which Angela Merkel is standing fast. But there is among intellectuals, academia, media, students, a saying that, okay, we're tired. And it is, of course, connected to anti-Semitism because it's a sort of a blame, why an accusation. Why are we tired? Because you exaggerate the use, the speech of the memory of the Holocaust. So that's Germany. There is a strengthening of extreme right-winger parties in Europe. You know that, the elections in Germany, in other places. And but that's not only what you see is not only a strengthening of each in his own country, but in last year, 2016, there was a conference of representatives of all extreme right parties in Europe, be it the Jobbik in Hungary and Golden Dawn in Greece and the Swedish Democrats and the Dutch ones, etc., etc. And they all gathered and formed what they call European Fortress. The European Fortress. Why a fortress? Well, against immigrants, against the left that wants the immigrants. That has not been seen before, and this is also certainly a cause for concern. There is a radicalization of Muslims. We said before, some 30, at least 30 million, there are people who say there are other estimations. Let's stick to the lower one. In Europe, from the center of Europe to the west and north, Scandinavian, and there is a radicalization of the second and third generation. Not necessarily the new immigrants. The new immigrants are busy surviving, studying a new language. The second and third generation of the former Muslims who came to Europe are radicalized. They are being tempted and lured by mosques in order to instill into them strong Muslim identity that doesn't allow them to be integrated in society because it's different, it's anti the West. And this radicalization is also also a cause for concern. Thank you.